If any one of you wants to put any question and get some idea clarified, Mataji is prepared to reply.
You should not, because your attention has to be free. At the time of your realization, when the Kundalini is awakened, all your attention is extracted within. And the Kundalini, while rising, takes it on its head or on her head and brings the attention outside the Sahasrara. So at that time, best thing is to let loose yourself, just sit down watching what is happening. Instead of putting any effort, it is an effortlessness that helps you the best. So no mantra is to be chanted. After realization, you must know what mantra is to be chanted, where there is a big science about it. So the complete tantra, what you call Kundalini, is there, but you must know how to handle it, what mantra is to be said, what is to be said, and which chakra lacks the things, and it is, you have to master it. And there are many here in Delhi also who have mastered it, so it's not difficult. Anybody can master it. It's not difficult. Even a little girl like Pradnya has mastered the Kundalini. She can do it. So why not you people can do it? So you have to just find out what are the chakras which are defective, and you can treat it also. Just now, those who are not realized, you've got your realization, no doubt. So you will go and meet those people at D288 Pandara Road, and there you go, and they will guide you as to what is to be done future, and go deep into it. Make yourself established and be a master of Kundalini. All that is Guhya Guhya Taram, I have told them, and you will get all the knowledge about it.
What is the purpose of the Lord?
Now, that's a very good question, is why the universal consciousness, yes, why the, yes, it is all deliberate, and why it is kept sleeping in the human beings. Now, in the growth of evolution from a small amoeba, you come to a human stage. At the human stage, articulation takes place, means like a shell of the egg is developed. For the egg to develop, the shell is developed, you are made limited. Through the growth of your ego and superego within yourself, your Brahmarandhra is closed down, your Talu is closed down, and you are left to yourself. I'll tell you in an analogy by which you'll understand. For example, if I have to use this mic, first of all, it is developed somewhere away from the mains, then it is brought and put to the mains. In the same way, a human being is cut from the mains. He is given eyeness for him to develop his instrument, his awareness in such a manner that when he receives the means, he can communicate it, he could understand it. And for that development, articulation was done. Just like an egg is made in a shell for protection and for its growth. And then when the chick is ready in that shell, it is broken by the mother here. Just like I break your Brahmarandhra, is the same way it's done. Now the idea of Atma Dhyan is, if it is read in the books, it's rather difficult to make you understand. But what happens with the rise of Kundalini? First of all, when you enter into that infinite thing, some people rise like steep, we can say a very strong jet like speed they get. But some of them rise very slowly. And then we can see the stages into which they rise. The first thing that happens is that you become thoughtless, but you are aware. First stage that happens is thoughtless awareness. Thoughtless awareness means that you start watching the thoughts. That means you are separated from yourself. Like you were in the water and now you jump onto the boat and you see the water now. So that you are separated. This is what happens. Those who have gradual ascent, you become thoughtlessly aware, which we call in the Hatha Yoga as Asampragyat Samadhi. Of course, according to them, it's a very higher state. But you become thoughtlessly aware and the vibrations start flowing from your hand, by which you know that something is flowing. you start getting cool breeze from me and you start getting cool breeze from other sahajogis, and when you give it to others, you find it is flowing. This you can say is the first thing that happens. That means you become collectively conscious of another personality. This is the first thing that happens. The second stage in which into you jump is nirvikalpa. Means in that stage you become dotless. Then you don't ask me questions. There are some people who are like that here. So they have no questions, they have felt it, they have known it. I say it in a different way, that supposing I give you 1,000 rupees. Now if you do not spend it, how will you know what is the value of that? You will say, what you have given us 1,000, what is that? You have just given us vibrations. But once you start using it and you see the tremendous powers you have got, and the powers of this so-called, I mean what you call just ordinary vibrations, some people think like that because it's so easily available, it happens to you so sahaja that you do not understand the value of it. But once you start using them and you see the tremendous thing you have got it, the bliss and the joy that flows into you, you come into the state of doubtless awareness. The third one, I would say, when the complete self-realization is established. Now, in the thoughtless awareness, as you can say that now, supposing now, as we have got justice sitting here. So when he is a justice, he has certain powers. In the same way, when you rise to the thoughtless awareness, you have certain powers, by which you can give awakening to people. You just move your hands, the kundalini of people will move. It's surprising, but it does. You can move the hands and you can see the kundalini, you can feel the kundalini of other persons, you can feel the chakras of another person, it happens. Only with thoughtless awareness. But with doubtless awareness, you start giving them realization. Absolutely, you can, just like that you can. And with higher self-realization, what happens? That you just become a sakshi. No problem, you never catch anything. You see, normally what happens, a person comes to you, you place your hands towards that person, and you feel, oh, disgusting, this fellow is burning me. You don't like it. Because the chakras of that person are burning your fingers and you know it's burning. Then sometimes you catch also, you get involved into it. But later on, when you are completely self-realized, you become a nirlepa. You do not catch any such things. And you rise into the realm where you are into complete vairagya. You're just flowing. You are in the sakshi state. But after this, these three stages is the state of God's realization, in which you start controlling the nature completely. Some people, of course, through Hatha Yoga, they try to control certain nature, but that's just upside down. We started from the top, go down. First of all, let us go to the divine state and then come down, then establish into the, we control the nature. See, if you can control the, say, ray, you can control the sun, all these things can be done. But that is, you see, you lose interest in those things, but automatically you can do it. For example, when I was going to see one Maharaj like that, who is a very evolved soul, and he has got it through his, you see, thousands of years of tapascharya. So he was sitting down there and he was pouring rain. The rain was pouring down and he didn't want me to get drenched. So he was trying to control rain. I know he can control rain, but the rain was pouring and he didn't know what to do. He was so disgusted with himself. When I went up, he said, did you want to kill my ego that you didn't allow the rain to stop? I said, no, it was not so. You see, I am a mother. So I told him very sweetly that I know you have bought a sari for me, and if I were not drenched, you would not give me the sari. So I just wanted the rain to. And that's how, you see, the little ego that was there, that I'm controlling the rain, dropped down. So it's a thing that happens automatically. You do not want to do it, but just it happens. You just don't want to bother about these things, but it happens. Wherever you are, it just happens. That is the state where you start rising into God's realization. When you are in God's realization, whether you are sitting here or anywhere, you can see things, you can influence people, you can help them, you can do lot of things sitting down anywhere. You may sit in the Himalayas. There are many people like that who are sitting in the Himalayas and helping. So they can do it and they are one. For example, this gentleman about whom I am telling you, who is a very great saint, he saw at my time, at the time of my birth, everything that happened. He knows about my past lives for thousands of years. He recognizes me much better. There's another one who came to see me from Amarnath, who is 300 year old. He is also of the same time. And he also said all those things. But you see, their style is different and your style is different. You are people like Ganesha. They are not. They still catch. You don't know. This man, 300 year old man, had some patches on his body. I said, what have you done, Anagnath Baba? How did you get these? He said, I caught it from one man, horrible fellow. He had come, he touched me. I said, you got it. All right, I'll take it out for you. And then he said, what about you? I said, not me. I do not get it. I'm a mother. Mother never catches other children. In the same way, you people also don't catch. Now, there are some people here who have cured cancer. They have never caught anything from anybody. So, you see, you have much more powers because you are people who are simple, who are like Sri Ganesh. Because Sri Ganesh has much more powers than any one of the deities there are. Because he's so simple, he's so dedicated to the mother. We are living in this world because we have to become the instrument in the hands of God. He wants to use us. You see, we have to be a good instrument into his hand. For example, an artist has a brush. Now, why is the brush there? For the artist to use the brush. Now, I will tell you a very sweet story about it. Once Radhaji was very jealous of the Murali that Sri Krishna was carrying on his lips. So she asked, what is your speciality? She asked the Murali, what is your speciality that you are all the time near the lips of my Lord? So she said that my speciality is that I have no speciality. I have become a hollow person. The melody is flowing through me. He is using me as just an instrument. And when I laugh at the people when they say that you are being played. Actually, I am just watching like a sakshi, a witness. And if I stand anywhere in between, then his melody will be spoiled. This is the purpose. And if you do not achieve that purpose, then all this recklessness comes in, this tension comes in, this problem comes in, which we can say in a gross way that your parasympathetic is taxed. Once the parasympathetic is taxed, then you start thinking that what are we to do, where are we to jump now? This whole petrol is being exhausted in this body. But once you open out to the mains, it starts pouring into you. And you are absolutely relaxed.
How long does it take for a very normal person?
It just takes a second, if you are ready. For every ordinary person, it really takes a second. When it rises, it takes a second to rise. But what happens, that Kundalini is your mother. So now supposing your mother is coming to see you, and you are sick. So first of all, what she will do is to see that your sickness is removed. Then she sees that you are mentally upset. So she looks after your mental problem. Then she sees that you are wrongly placed spiritually. So she corrects you. And ultimately she blesses you. So if somebody is in temperance, impiety, who has got a good health, of normal health, who is leading a normal married life, he is the best suited. And there are some people who have got it just like that. But some people are sick. They have some troubles because they have gone through various ordeals of life. They have been troubled and tortured, they have got some mental problems, the mother has to soothe them. So there is, you see, you cannot say that when this seed is going to sprout, it will sprout. Can you say that at this day the flowers will appear? Can you say that at this day there will be all fruits coming? No, you cannot. There is no time for living things. It works itself. It is a living process. So it works itself. It works for the organism, that is yourself, and then it clicks itself. That is what is sahaja. Kya kahe?
Whether I will get the chance to awaken my feelings.
Realization?
Yes.
Yes, why not? Why not? I am here only for that. Zarur, zarur, zarur. Avashya. Avashya. Achha, aap logo mein se jo chahte. Haan, haan, bete.
Aapne kaha, after everyone has been cultivated or developed, then one is going to the higher stage, self-realization. Then he becomes so to say a sattva, sees everything undisturbed, and with an unruffled mind, all that happens doesn't touch him really. So that when he reaches that stage, he becomes so to say, you attain the highest attainment as it were, or he becomes a part of the divine. Now when this divine state has been reached, how does he react to all the misery? You would say that he is only a witness and doesn't really worry much about it. Now this is what has happened, so to say, to all those people.
Right, and for anybody who is not realized, that should be the question, that you see around such a lot of misery. Now he has asked two questions, you see, he has confused two questions. The first one about misery, the second about overpopulation. So first I will answer the first question of misery. Now, you say that there are miseries. Accept it. There are miseries. And miseries are there because of human beings themselves, because they haven't got the divine within themselves. If they have divine, they will not dominate. They will not bear domination. They will be different people. But we can say one thing, how we reduce the miseries of people when you get realized. Now see, I have told you there are 7 chakras in the human beings. When they are awakened, what happens? Let us see. First of all, your physical problems are solved. Your health improves. You lead a very healthy life. You will be amazed, and in Sahaja Yoga, nobody dies before he is 70 years of age. He leads a very, very healthy life to begin with. First misery of physical life is over. Not only that, he leads a physically good life, but he makes other physically all right. He makes them physically fit without taking a single pie from them. The vibrations that flow from him, he cures them, and the other person gets all right. Now, you, as I have told you, there are people here who have treated so many people, have cured so many people without taking a single pie, because this love is flowing and that cures them. So your physical problem is solved. Then the second problem is your emotional problem. The person suffers emotionally. They become emotionally disturbed. Sometimes there are possessions, they come into it from their subconscious mind, and there are problems from the emotional side. Now, after realization, people become sakshi in the sense that emotionally they do not get involved into the things, that they do not feel disturbed about it, but they see the thing. I will give you a very concrete example. I had a grandchild, first grandchild born in my family. This child was born with a heart which was aorta and pulmonary vein, there is a coartation, which cannot be cured because it's a basic problem. And I knew about it the day she was born. But I was silent, and on the 6th day I said to the doctor, you must take her under x-ray and see what is the thing. Doctor was surprised. She said, why are you saying so? Such a little child should not be exposed to x-ray. I said, you take her. And I took her secretly and showed her to the doctor, and they found out the enlargement of the heart. Now, when I came home, I didn't tell my daughter. I didn't tell my husband, who was to come from Delhi. When he came back, with very great introduction, I told him. Immediately he fainted. He's a very healthy man. I mean, that way emotionally he's supposed to be a very sensible person, very balanced, but he fainted. We told this to the father of the child, he fainted. My daughter fainted. They couldn't bear it. I took the child to the hospital. I admitted her in the hospital because the doctor said they have to do other tests. Then we had to take the child to America, and I knew the child was going to die. But I said, all right, if they think the child is to be taken, I took. None of them could take. They couldn't take the child. I took there. The so-called miserable people actually are overdoing things by which they are spoiling everybody's life and making themselves miserable also. The way we talk of our miseries actually are so exaggerated. I do not know if they are really that miserable the way they talk about, and they cannot do anything about it, because unless and until you are separated from the problem, how are you going to solve it? You see, you are to be separated. Unless and until you are a doctor, you are not going to operate. Supposing you are the patient, how are you going to operate yourself? So the doctor in you must be separated. This is what the Sahaja Yoga does. Because you are the patient and you are the doctor, that's where the whole thing is more exaggerated. If you find any doctor being sick, he'll be the worst patient. Have you seen that in practice? It is so. That's why those who are miserable are much more miserable than they are really, because they themselves do not know how to cure it. So the emotional problem is solved like this. Now, then there is another problem which we face all the time, is of our dharma, of our dignity. How to be dignified, how to be ourselves, the spiritual problem. And that is solved, no doubt, because there you find the divine flowing through. You really become a dynamic personality. Apart from that, for these worldly things, I have to tell you another things which happen to people who are Sahaja Yogis. That is, your Lakshmi is awakened. Now you know what is Lakshmi. Such a person cannot become a beggar. Cannot. A Sahaja Yogi cannot become a beggar because his Lakshmi is awakened. He is looked after. see, there is God Almighty who is looking after you. This is the sin against God, that all the time you are so insecure. The one who has created you, the one who is looking after you, is going to look after you everywhere. But you want to run after other things. You want to do smuggling, you want to do all kinds of things, you want to cut each other's throat. And then you want to see that you are happy. You cannot. You have to depend on Him and on His grace. And a person who is realized, he is like a bacha. He's the king. He's always the queen. He doesn't bother. I can tell you about myself. I never feel I have dearth of money or dearth of anything. Never. You see, if you ask me, I can sleep on the ground. Now perhaps I was born in a very rich family and my husband is quite rich. But if you ask me, I can sleep anywhere. I can do without food for days together. It doesn't matter, all the time people talk of eating, eating, eating. How much do we eat? There's no need to eat such a lot. That's why some people are poor. Some people eat such a lot that there are some people who are poor. But automatically your attention from food and all that drops out. You just get it. If you get it, well and good. If you don't get it, well and good. For this morning I had no breakfast and all that. I didn't know that I had no. And if I had not even my lunch, I would not. Because this body is filled with energy you don't need. Actually, this is the first time the energy is filling you. Then you give vibrations. In Rahuri, there's one university where they have experimented. In the university, first time they have experimented in an agricultural university with these vibrations. They have found that the growth of all these wheat was 10 times more. They found that the fruits that came out of it were beautiful and they were so tasty and so lasting. They found that when the cow was given vibrated water, she started giving Indian cow milk like an Australian cow. But I cannot write a guarantee check for you. That is one thing. So all the miseries, so-called, will drop out. Now the overpopulation problem, that's very interesting, I'll tell you what is it. Why there is such a overpopulation? You see, the congenial atmosphere for the Rakshasas and for the brutes, giving chance for brutes to come as human beings. Once this congenial atmosphere for them disappears, only the saintly will come, and they are not so many. And they will not need also so many things. A saintly person doesn't need much. With very little, he's so satisfied, he doesn't want. You see, he's a bacha. It's only the mental attitude that makes us bhikaris. Otherwise, we are not. We are very rich people. What else? Now I would say that really some who are really hungry will ask for the ultimate, but those who are not will be asking me questions. As I say, I have cooked the food for you, and those who are hungry will say, Mother, give us now, it's too much now. These people are just wasting our time. We are very hungry. And that's the stuff. And that's the thing you should ask for. That's the real thing you should ask for, and you should get it.